Yep. We got it. We got it, guys. Well, I felt like she was gonna win right after prelim, so this is no surprise, and she was doing it. She was staying consistent. It was beautiful. She has an aura. She has a glow to her. Gosh, I'm excited for her this year. You guys, is Philippines about to win Miss Universe? Oh my gosh. Y'all may just win Miss Universe this year. Makati is for sure up, basically, yes. There you have it, your new Miss Universe Philippines. Love her! Well, congrats everyone, beautiful representative here. Oh my gosh. I'm so emotional. Look at her! Yeah, even with that updo, she reminds me so much of the 90s. She's timeless. She's wow. I love it. I love how Pia closes it out. Wow. Oh, you're so welcome for waking up early. Yes. Now I'm just excited. Now I'm awake. Okay, I'm doing it. Doing the recap right now then. Wow. Exciting, right? Very excited. She's stunning.
Oh my God. Ay, Dios mío. Oh my God. Either one. They both deserve it, but come on, Celeste.
The new Miss Universe Philippines 2022 is Pasay City.
Oh my God. I'm so freaking happy right now. Oh my God, Celeste. Oh my God. This is a full circle moment for Celeste. From being bashed and being told that she was not enough since the very beginning, not just of Miss Universe Philippines, but since the beginning of her pageantry journey in the Philippines, to now getting the national title of the most important pageant in the country. Oh my God. I'm still shaking. I'm so happy, you guys. You know what? I'm not even Filipino myself, but this is like my pattern. This is like, I don't care. Cuba does not go to Miss Universe. I'm rooting for y'all. Justice. Justice was served. Oh my God. You know what? Actually, I'm just going to say as well, I'm very proud of Celeste, but I'm also very proud of her team. For those of you who don't know, like, Celeste is part of the camp, which is a smaller camp in the Philippines. And they have worked so, so hard to really come up with a girl that will be able to place, to come up with a girl that will be, you know, taken seriously. Last year, they trained Victoria Velasquez. They also trained Sam, But now coming back with Celeste was kind of a risk because so many people were, you know, just discrediting Celeste because of her previous stint in Miss Earth. And now look at her. Look at her. I just would have loved to be there. But you know that now that Celeste won, I have to go to Miss Universe International. You know that, right? I gotta be there and root for my girl.
So just going right to second runner-up, Taegeek. Oh my god, there won't be like holding hands? First runner-up, but my heart's beating out of my chest. Misamis Oriental. Oh, they're giving, okay, thank god. You guys are helping me in the comments. Oh, okay. Miss Universe Charity, okay. Woo! Behold, Miss Universe Charity is behold, you guys. So she's technically second runner-up, right? So I was right in my final predictions. Oh my god. Shut up, you guys. Oh my god. Okay, so my final predictions is actually pretty right. Okay, thank you guys for your clarification in the comments. This is my final two! Sorry, you guys. I'm so excited. The name she's gonna call is the new Miss Universe Philippines. I'm literally yelling. Sorry, guys. I think it's gonna be Pasay. It has to be Pasay, do you think? Or is it gonna be Makati? It's gonna be Pasay. It's gonna be Pasay. Miss Universe Philippines is gonna be Pasay. If so, my predictions is spot on. Spot on. Literally 100%. Pasay. Pasay. Oh my god, she did it! Oh my, Miss Pasay has won it. And you guys, okay, if you're gonna put the throwing up face, I'm gonna block your comments. Goodbye. Miss Pasay has won Miss Universe Philippines 2022. So you guys, I'm super proud to say I predicted exactly the finals. In my final predictions, I said second runner-up, Bohol, Miss Charity, Bohol, first runner-up, Makati, and winner, Pasay. Look at her wearing the crown, oh my god. I'm seriously crying for her. Oh my gosh. I think she's amazing. And look at Harnaz is there. Oh my god. I literally have goosebumps, you guys. Oh.
Makati or Pasay? I got my top three. Okay. Just Makati or Pasay. Look. Yes. I'm happy. I'm good.
Philippines.
And girl, then you better scream Celeste Cortesi. You'd better scream Celeste Cortesi. I don't know what to tell you. Celeste Cortesi. Pasay. Pasay City! Pasay City! Pasay City! Celeste Cortesi, you did the damn thing, girl. You did it. You did it. Look, my number twos. They come out swinging for the fences. Oh my gosh, good job, Celeste. This was a fight. Some of the girls held back, for sure. I was right about Cebu Province, about her holding back. She certainly did. But this certainly was a fight. A lot of the girls came out swinging. And I'm happy with this. I'm good with this. I'm chill with this. I feel like the boo-boos were done a little bit of an injustice. Bagyao City was so much better. I asked for Bagyao City on her A game. Bagyao City was on her A game today. Absolutely, it's exactly what I asked for. I said, please Bagyao City, bring your A game. Bagyao City brought her A game and she did great. And honestly, like she was one of my favorites in this competition. But the girls fought in this competition. So this was fun to watch. Preliminaries, I was like, well, wasn't as fun. Finals night, fun. This was fun. This was a show that I needed to see. And I'm very happy I got to see it and sit through it and avoid spoilers because I am not disappointed whatsoever in our new Miss Universe Philippines Queen, Celeste Cortesi from Pasay. We'll be going to Miss Universe. In the comment section below, let me know what you think about that. Do you think Celeste has a chance? Do you think she is the absolute front runner for the next season of Miss Universe. She's going to the big stage. How much of a chance do you think the Philippines has this year? I know a lot of people are very happy with this decision, including me. None of us really have much to complain about, so rejoice.